हेलो पीपल, दिस इज़ देवांग एंड माय फेलो टीममेट्स आर सिद्धेश, अदिति, सुशांत एंड मेहुल एंड आर एप्लीकेशन इज मेडिकमेंट। सो इन मेडिकमेंट वी कैन डोनेट यूज्ड और अनयूज्ड मेडिसिन टू द एनजीओस बिकॉज आर हेल्थ इज फंडामेंटल पार्ट ऑफ बीइंग ह्यूमन। विदाउट इट वी हैव नथिंग। अर्लियर द कलेक्शन ऑफ मेडिसिन डोनेशंस आर डन बाय सेटिंग कैंप्स और पीपल कैन डायरेक्टली गो टू द एनजीओस टू डोनेट एज इट वॉज एन हीडियस टास्क। As we know, there is pandemic going on, so NGOs can't use the earlier methods. Hence, we created a common platform for all the NGOs and the users where people are connected on online portal. It is convenient and safe as no common application for all NGOs has been developed yet. So, let's continue. This is our user portal where user can sign up or log in if he already have an account. Here, I'm creating a new account. So let's put the details over here, such as name, email ID, phone number and address. Let's click on continue. We have provided the OTP verification as it is very secure way to authenticate. These are the so let's put our OTP first. Let's verify it. And this is the home page for our user application. This is account information where user can edit his name. Let's say continue. Let's check. The name is already updated. So after that, here we have FAQ sections where the questions. After that, about us, what our mission is, what basically Medicomand is. Then user can log out. Here user can change his profile icon. Let's say such as this image. The profile picture has been updated. These are the guidelines for donating medicines where we have mentioned what you can or can't donate, like unsealed bottles. Now we are donating a medicine here. So we can donate medicine from here. First we have to put the medicine name, strength, expiry date. Expiry date, which is very important for tablet to be donated, and it should be visible on the tablet. It is must. Let's say pills, quantity, front image, back image. So these are the images. If we put the expiry date wrong, then it will give you error that medicine is already expired. Save, add another medicine. Add image, front image, and then back image. Let's say save. Here is the submit button. We can add the submit, then request send, and our submission is done. And the last option in our app is past donation, where user can see his previous donation done by the same. This is the date where when user is provided the donation with expiry date, medicine name and quantity. So this is it. This is our user side portal. So moving on to the NGO portal. This is an NGO panel where NGOs can log in if they already have an account. Let me just log in first. So this is an NGO panel. Here we can add medicine by clicking on create. Let's add one medicine. Let's say ID 5. मेडिसिन नेम टाइप क्वांटिटी इफ वी मिस एनी फील्ड इट विल शो एन एरर सो लेट्स से क्वांटिटी 10 एंड सेव इट सो यू कैन सी द प्रॉम्प्ट एलिमेंट हैज बीन क्रिएटेड दिस इज द एलिमेंट वी कैन एडिट द एलिमेंट एज वेल एंड इफ यू वांट टू सी दैट एलिमेंट हियर एलिमेंट हैज बीन क्रिएटेड हियर वी कैन एडिट इट और एज कैन से वी कैन डिलीट द एलिमेंट एज वेल सो लेट्स जस्ट एड वन मोर एलिमेंट quantity 10 and let's say save. As you can see the both element has been added here. So now the NGOs can see those donors who have the most matching requirements which will be displayed in the donors panel. So let's see here. These are the donors who put the request for that particular medicine, who put the donations for that particular medicine. So our application scans the request from NGO and users and make the matching pairs. As you can see, the request has been approved and simultaneously the changes has shown in the NGO panel. As you have seen, the status has been approved. Because of these donors, we got the particular medicine. So now the NGOs can contact the donor directly from the donors panel to get the medicine. So let's move forward to the admin portal. So this is an admin portal where admin can see the NGOs and users as well. Let me first log in. Let's say sign in. So these are the NGOs and these are users. So this is the NGO names from whom NGO has taken the medicine and status has been approved for both the medicines. In users, changes has been done. As you can see the NGO column, this particular user donating the medicine to particular NGO. Since we haven't find the matching pairs for this particular medicine, this request, some requests are still in pending. So continuing to the Firebase database. Now I will be showing the database. We have used Firebase to store our data as it is easy to use and has number of tools to develop high quality apps at much faster rate. It's a cloud computing service model. It includes authentication functionality, a real-time database, fast and secured web hosting. So here is the daily active count you can see by the Firebase. This is the database. First we'll go to the authentication. Now you can see the number of users who have authenticated using OTP. And then after that, it's a database. This is a database. So here you can see first I've added the user in the user portal. So this is the data of that of particular user and which medicines he donated. We all can see all the medicines he have donated in the database. These are the two medicines I've shown you in the user portal. After that, my details has been stored in the database with all the donations I've done. Now coming to the NGO database. Here, Umeed NGO, which we added recently, is shown here. We can clearly see the medicine list has been updated. All the data has been updated in the real time just because of Firebase. Hence our application is secure and user friendly. As you can see, we have created a mobile application for user, website for NGO and admin panel. We have connected these three applications using Firebase database which work at real time. Our system provides a common platform for users and all the NGOs to communicate in an easier way. Thank you.